And again, this goes back to my opening theme, where we are going as an NCAA Division I athletic program. Agnes Farinato, her staff, and her players have put us on the map. 24 wins, two straight seasons. Second time in a row going to the NCAA tournament, defeating several top 20 teams, beating Notre Dame. You don't want to hear me talk anymore, but I know you want to hear our head women's basketball coach. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Sarah.
Thank you so much. Chuck Knowles, I just want to tell you, Joe Giordano was really nice. Like, I don't know about y'all, but he lost me on about the 10th meter thing with the pool. And Joe Giordano reached over to me and he said, "You know, stop talking." He said, "I just want to know, does it have any water in it?" I mean, it went right over my head. But I just want to say thank you so much for having me. And Gertrude and John Peterson, honestly, from the bottom of my heart, you guys, you are just an inspiration to me. And you, what you have done for me in 5 years since I came to the university has been amazing. And I tell everybody, and I will tell you, and it is great to get up here to Erie, but I have the most beautiful home in the world. And if all of you could have the home I have, my living room is magnificent, and that's my court. And my kitchen is my office. And it overlooks my kitchen. Many people have kitchens that, oh, like in the case of the Petersons, it overlooks, what is it, the, which river? Lake Erie. Well, my kitchen, oh, and oh, y'all, it's beautiful. I mean, but my kitchen overlooks the Peterson court. And my bedroom, that's like our locker rooms. And the graciousness of Coach John and Coach Gertrude, it just goes beyond words. There's not a game that goes by, and this is true. There's not a game that goes by that when the game is over, and I get up to my office, or I get out on the bus, the team bus, if we're on the road, we always have voice messages, and you know, Dave, you know how that is, and Steve, he knows how that is, because if y'all don't like what we do, you call Steve. And if you, and the papers, they just write about it the next day, you know. Poor Donna, I am sure she went through hell when she was the interim AD because of the calls that you guys make. But my phone, the messages I get, usually I get a message from John Peterson. "Coach, it's halftime. And I'm liking the stats. Mallory Wynn, 3 for 4. Shavonte Zellis, 8 for 9. Mercedes, oh, she's got 2 fouls. Please tell her to keep her hands to herself." And it goes on and on. Am I right, Coach Peterson? I like this. This halftime, like I'm going right in. It's such amazing. But I believe in you, and I know when Zinnia Stewart starts to play defense, Candace Wiggins won't have 42 points. And I know we is the operative word. We will be victorious. And it says, you know, press 1 for something, something, 3 to delete, 9, and I save it. And the next message, "Coach, we did it. What a marvelous win. Mallory wins 7 for 9. 6 assists. I'm like, dang. And then I get on the bus, and Shay Ralph is here. Shay is my assistant coach, and I'd like to just, Shay, thank you so much. It's a pleasure that you're here with us today. And what I do, oftentimes, John will say, "Gertrude and I," and I don't really know where this is, but maybe the owners are in the house. They go to a local bar, and they watch the games at their TV games. And this year we were lucky, we had 9 games on TV. And they go, and I guess if you're the Petersons, you get it put up on the big screen. And they watch it, and he keeps stats. And I get on the team bus, and there's many messages that don't let my team hear. But I always let the team hear John and Gertrude's message, because it's from the heart, And they are always inclusive with we. And I think how special. And tonight, that's what it's all about. We're here to represent Pitt. I am honored to be here. I'm honored to be here with Steve and Donna and your roommate. I'm going to give her a shout out. Okay, Donna, clap for her. Will you please clap for her, Donna? She's been clapping for you all night. All right. It's great. And to be with the other coaches, the first 4 years, I didn't have the opportunity to come up to Erie. And my associate head coach, Jeff Williams, he always came. And Jeff sends his best to all of you. And he was really upset. You know, I said, Jeff, I said, it only took us to get to the Sweet 16 for them to request me. I said, so yeah, I kicked him to the curb, and I don't play golf. But Jeff will be back. He sends his regards. We had a great year. It was really, really a wonderful year. But the most impressive thing about the year was that we graduated, everybody. And Mallory Wayne graduated a year ago. Mal's graduated a year ago, and she's working on her master's. And hopefully in September, she will be going to Europe to play ball. Mercedes Walker, an update. She has made the Houston Comets team, and she's playing professionally in the WNBA. Carlisle Lim graduated with a 3-8. And she just signed a contract about 2 weeks ago with the Korean national team. And she will be leaving for Korea next week to play. And we also had a junior who graduated, Shavante Zellis. And Shavante Zellis is a great, great, great student athlete. She's a phenomenal player. If she stays on track, I think I can say next year she could get drafted in the WNBA in the first 10 or the first round for sure, which would really be another milestone. As I tried to go around and talk to some people, I just tried to introduce myself. And, you know, you have two different groups. Mrs. Williams, you know, I do want to just say, when I introduced myself over here, she told me, you know, I'm Mishia Williams, Mom. Do y'all know Mishia?
Yeah.
Yeah, does everybody know her? Yeah, you know her, yeah. Well, I knew her too, okay? She blew me off like, bam, you know? And she chose that other school up the road, you know? And then her grandmom, you're so beautiful, grandmom, and I know that I probably talked to you on the phone many times recruiting. And I said to them just a minute ago, their daughter goes to Penn State, well, did you ever regret your decision? And they kind of didn't say anything. I said, that's okay, just don't answer it, you know? I mean, we won't say that we were in the Sweet 16 and y'all had a losing season, but that's okay. You know? And then I got my buddies over here, okay? I have my buddies over here in the corner, and the very first table I go to, and Donna, you're going to have to teach me how to handle this situation, okay, babe? You got, like, I think I'm pretty good in a social setting, but I go over here to this crew, and I say, you know, hi, I'm Agnes Farinato. I'm from Pitt. Thank you all so much. Like, your support is so important to all of us at the head table. And Dr. Phil over there says, oh, we're from Notre Dame. I'm like, oh, okay. And I'm like, okay, so, and what's your point? And then I look, and on his tie, like, you know how Pitt people, we have, like, Pitt ties. And it's pretty big. Pitt. Donna has a pin on Pitt. No, he's got the tiniest little Andes. Like, you know, you need reading glasses to when you're older. Upset them to knock them out of the Big East. Okay? So, Dr. Phil, you're all right in my book. You're all right. I did want to just say, only big dreams. The sky's the limit. I appreciate being invited here. Shay and myself and Jeff Williams and Caroline McCombs and Mercedes Walker and Mallory Wynn, all we want to do is represent you. We want to represent the best of Pitt, both academically and athletically. And I hope when you open up the paper, you turn on the news, or you listen to the radio, And may it be wrestling, where we had a national champion and Randy was the coach of the year, or you know, our illustrious swimming coach with a brand new pool, $2 million, I think was the figure he threw out there. All kinds of meters, and we're about this much big or short, or what, I don't know what all that means, but I'm just saying, we hope we make you proud. And then lastly, I'm just going to use a line that I swore I would never use again. And Dad, I think it's really cool you're here. I just want to tell you. You know what? Joe, you know how cute that Joe's father, that's you right there, Dad. Yeah. How cool that Joe, your dad's dad is here. Joe, I just wish my parents were alive. So I just, you know what? I'm going to claim them for the night. Okay? So you're with me too, okay? And Grandma, you can be my grandma, okay? I hope that you guys, when you read about the student athletes, when you read about your student athletes, I hope in your heart and soul, you're inclusive, like John and Gertrude Peterson. And you say, wow, they made us really proud. Thank you. I enjoyed it and have a great night.